Hello everyone. You may not know it, but this is actually a long overdue video. I paid for the shipping for these July of this year, and they came in around November. So I've been waiting impatiently for these for a long time. So they've actually been kind of like the figures that I've been looking forward to for the past couple years. Lots of small details, a lot of small items, and the whole set together was pretty expensive. So I've been wanting to unbox this for you, for the channel, to share it with you, and I'm really excited to open it with you. As you can see here, lots of little small pieces, lots of little food items and plates all separate. So a lot to keep track of. Definitely the box will be handy for any future transitions with it because I don't want to lose any of these pieces. The top layers of plastic were tied together, so I ended up having to get a nail clipper just to separate them. It would have taken me way too long to try and unwrap the tie that was knotted together at the bottom. Kept missing that there are little small clear stands to help some of the characters stand up straight, specifically for Mori and the little Mandragoras, but it took me a second to realize that they were there. Velvet's figure, I cannot stress enough how awkward her balance is. You have to keep her like right on the edge of her chair or she will fall over. She will fall over so many times. And when I've been trying to set up, even like further in this recording, when I've been trying to set her up, she is the first to fall and just take a lot of things down with her. So if you have her, I'm sure you've been through this pain, but it's a challenge. These little guys are so cute. I love Odin's Sphere. The mini game of doing all the little foods was really like what I would keep coming back to with Odin's Sphere. And like when I want to play Odin's Sphere again, really, I just want to start making the food and collecting the little guys, even though maybe it's a little bit grotesque because we're, I guess, hunting them for food, but they're very cute. Mercedes and Gwendolyn, not nearly as difficult to position or place. They tend to just stay in their spot, unlike Velvet, truly the most difficult figure. And then here we have the full set, all set up. There's a lot of food, and probably you don't necessarily need to display them all together, but it seems like a shame not to. So I ended up pulling out a little raiment table that I had from another set of small items, and it seemed to work just to kind of give a place for the extra food to set. While I was showing these figures, I thought it would be a nice addition to just kind of show the rest of my Odin Sphere collection, because it's pretty substantial. Some of these are actually new. The Gwendolyn figure I got during her second release, so I'm excited to have her. And I love this Velvet figure too. The little Alice figure, if you've watched my 10 top figures that I own video, you'll have seen her before. And then I also have these two Fat Company releases of Gwendolyn and Mercedes. I love how colorful the full set is. I really enjoy all these characters and the different aesthetics they lean into, and just how these figures tend to really hone in on the details of the art style and of the characters. So I'm really happy to have these and really excited to have them up on my shelf. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you enjoyed this, if you've got any of these figures, or if there's anything from my collection that you would like to see more of. Just let me know, and we can talk more about anime figures.